get ready. It's going to be pretty crazy. Could have the upset of a century, or we could just be like, ah, of course Nessie was going to win. Don't be stupid, Tasteless Artosis, the casting archon.
Who can be followed on Twitter? Artosis, call me Tasteless.
This is...
I am Nessie!
Time to turn a nerd into nerd soup.
When I call this out and we get a shot of his face, you make the Tails voice.
I don't.
Over here in the upper right, we have
MVP Tainter.
I don't remember what I did before.
No problem, Sonic.
There you go. That's good enough.
My last time was better.
It's all right.
Can you do the ST voice for me?
What is an ST voice? Is that what I was doing before?
Just anything super manly. Anything angry. Anything that is condescending. Anything like that.
Time to make this nerd lick my nerd boots.
It's like really gross because he's his nerd stomping boots. His Robble Stomp boots.
It has like the brains mush of his other friends on him already.
Yeah, man.
If Nesty was a Mortal Kombat character, Tasteless, would he be Goro because he has four hands to macro and micro with, or would he be Scorpion because he can make nerds get over here?
Oh, dude, I don't know.
Or would he be Raiden because he's the god of lightning?
That's good. Oh, this is a fun day today, Artosis.
It is indeed. I can't believe this has gone to the final game and Nesty has been called out. He's been summoned. You think Lance the Dragon Tamer from Pokemon is the last guy? No.
No, he's not. At all, no, actually. What? No. He's like the sniper.
Basically, Lance is MVP. This is the guy beyond that. This is the guy. This is actually even after that. He's all the legendary Pokemon and Mewtwo put into one.
Oh my god.
Yeah. Missing who? No.
Here come these Zerglings of Nesty. And they're Nesty Zerglings, so they're actually these like ripped leg muscles. Normally Nesty rides around on one. And then he hog ties another Zergling.
If Nesty was on the map, he'd be as big as half of it. He'd be like 7 Colossi tall and 8 Ultras wide.
Pretty much.
He does 1,000 splash damage to everything, everywhere on the map. He's just basically like nukes constantly going off. He's surrounded by medevacs. Can't be stopped, man.
It's a weird placement there, by the way.
Yeah, it is, actually.
Tails. He's actually like, I'm going to wall myself off for my
Nexus. But that's actually, that is, one cannon covers everything. I do believe, actually. I believe that counters everything.
Yeah, but he could just go around the cannon with his
Yeah, no, he definitely can. But I think we're going to see a gateway build in the back next to that other thing. Or a core, rather. But that is actually a really cute cannon. I really like that placement, in fact. Because normally you just kind of wall in the front ramp. Because it's so easy. It's a ramp. It's like, well.
It's like, hello.
It's easy. But,
oh, I see what he's doing. Okay, so the core is there. Then he can actually wall that in with a pylon if they do try to run around.
Sure, yeah.
Tails.
Nesty with no gas yet. Nesty told his opponent, he's like, listen, I'll beat you without one of the StarCraft resources. And he was like, oh my god, yeah, you're Zerg infestors, I hate him, don't use gas. And he's like, all right. And then he's like, oh wait, no! No minerals! He's like, too late, you already chose.
All right. So Nesty is actually taking the gold base right away. This strategy is made of balls. So many balls. Oh, he sees it, though.
It's not made of balls, it's made of hyperspheres, because it's Nesty's
Well, it's made
strategy.
Of steel balls.
Steel hyperspheres.
Yeah, hyperspheres, which are actually just Nesty's balls.
That's it. Fourth dimensional, baby.
Well,
we do have plus one on the way.
This is not a normal CDP opener, by the way, guys. Take the gold base like that. It looks like he's going to go for a warp gate timing attack.
Yeah, four gates he's going up to. Really quick plus one. Quite interesting so far. One of the problems is going to be that gold base... There's no real good place to fight against it if you're engaging it. If you look at other locations...
For Zerg, you mean, or for Protoss?
For Protoss. You know, normally you have, like, you're back to a wall when you fight an expansion, or you're back to a ramp or something like that, which makes force fields very powerful. But against the gold, on this particular map, it's a little bit harder. to actually engage the hatchery. It's a really look at all the area around it, right? It's hard to find an area there that force fields are going to be super effective against quick roaches and links.
Twilight Council on the way.
Ah, the plus one stalker. Okay, this is actually a build that we do see from time to time in Korea. I'm not sure if we've seen it PvZ in the GSL yet, but this is a popular build over here at the moment. A plus one blink stalker rush. It's a very crisp timing. It's quite nice. And I'm excited to see how good his micro is with it.
It's all about the micro, though.
Yeah.
Nesty, though, he never misses a beat when it comes to macro.
We even have a Dark Shrine on the way. This is really exciting.
You know what he's going to do? He's going to do the build.
Oh, wait a minute. He's micro. Not doing the build that I thought he was going to do, is he?
Well, he can come in here with the Stalkers, shoot down the Overseer, and maybe take this out. But it looks like Nesty already has a Spore Crawler.
And right now, we do have some roaches popping out. Only Zerglings and... only Zealots and sentries being made. This is not, in fact, the Blink Rush, which is actually a really cool build. I'll have to show you guys sometime. But,
These are a lot of roaches, Artosis.
Yeah, these roaches are going to do a good job. And with that Spine Crawler as well, this is already not looking very good. Already lost a sentry.
He needs to turn around.
Well, he's going to kill off a few of these roaches at least. Doing a great job with these force fields, but he's lost a lot of sentries. Doesn't have a lot of force fields left.
Well, the problem with Zealots is they're just not actually good against roaches at all.
The legend of Nesty grows tasteless with every roach volley.
Paul Bunyan's like complaining on a forum. He's like, I'm legendary too. It's like, shut up, Paul. Broadsleeper.
Seriously. He like tries the blue ox rush. Totally doesn't work. That was so patch 1.2. Well, these stalkers.
This is just not going to work. These are just too many roaches.
More Zerglings coming up right now. Four DTs being warped in. But there is a Spore Crawler.
Or he could go towards the other expansion.
There is a spore there as well.
But will he get a block?
He might.
Time?
Yeah. Well, Zerglings run by.
What?
Nesty is in trouble. That layer is only half done. If he just right clicks on that layer, that is pretty huge. Gonna kill some drones off first. This is big though.
Yeah, go over the layer.
Oh my God, he's gonna get the layer. More DTs being warped in as well. And suddenly, Nesty, after defending just so brilliantly, is in so much trouble.
Tails, oh my God. The entire IM team is like facepalming right now.
This is absolutely insane. Both teams are on the brink of their seats. On the brink of destruction.
He's going to get the spawning pool, and he's going to take out these eggs.
God.
He's going to turn him into scrambled
Sergei. Oh, my God. Tails like some scrambled. That's why he has so many tails. They act as an egg beater when Sonic's got a bad hangover. He's just like, Tails, come here. Tails is like,
Tails,
what,
I feel like balls.
He's like, you feel like Nesty? More gates being made by Tails. He is definitely all-inning from here. He's getting blink. He's getting his robo up.
He knows he has a sick
this
timing
actually,
attack.
I think Tails might possibly take this. Nesty is way up in supply, yes. And actually, he's getting drop and overlord speed right now, as well as an overseer, of course. But this the blink stalker build is going to be insanely powerful against this. Now, a lot of DTs are going to
be might actually
out.
Run from this. Just keep chasing me.
He does take out a few roaches, though.
Yeah,
and that's,
very nice.
I mean, that's, I guess, probably better than nothing. Another base. Oh, here we go. He's actually taking another base, so he's not even going to be like, all right, all in, which I thought he might do there because, you know, this is pretty good timing. ST is a little bit weak right now.
Those stalkers, like, blinked on top of himself. I don't understand.
Tails has to be careful here.
He's got to run for it.
It's a lot of roaches.
Oh, just get that one Zergling, then I'll get out of here. Isolation there.
Very good. Picking off a few roaches here and there. That's what he needs to do. Tails clawing his way back in. Like only animals with tails could do. Plus two attack for Tails. He's
going
to finish up here in a second. Yeah, he is. And a Hydralis Den as well.
Claw.
I think he's going to drop a lot of... you know what? The building placement...
It's going to be
he
a big
might actually be getting dropped because of that building placement. I don't put that beyond Nesty. Nesty is that smart. He's got the highest IQ ever measured by a human. Not that Chris Langford guy.
No, man.
It's actually an ST. Sorry, Chris Langford.
Chris Langford's like, I have a giant cranium.
I think that has something to do with intelligence.
And then ST's like, listen, I'm actually the greatest Zerg of all time.
Here we go. And this is, he has to blink up with his stalkers, but the rest of his units are stuck behind. They have to walk through a labyrinth of buildings to get into the main base.
He's going to force him to blink out.
Oh, my God.
He needs to go for these pylons.
Nesty.
Or actually, you know what? He might actually be able to win this. I mean, look at this angle. How on earth does a Protoss keep getting up in here?
Well, he's definitely going to have to blink some good force fields as well.
Actually, and nice positioning here.
Yeah,
by the Protoss.
Tails is doing great, man. He's doing great. But Nesty making it look Nesteezy.
Nesteezy.
Oh, Nesteezy.
Oh, another drop. He's not done yet. But I think now the Protoss army is in a pretty good position.
Wait a minute. I can't believe he's dropping right here. Is he going to actually have enough? Oh, it looks like yes, just enough right there.
Well, just barely enough. He can warp in more. Yeah. It's quite a travel distance for Nesty to reload.
Indeed it is. Nesty doing a lot of damage. By the way, he's taking another base during all this. 120 supply to 196.
He's
going to
hold this. He will actually hold this.
Yep. So, Tails, though, he is on three base. This is actually getting really, really close, Tasteless. Really, really, really close.
Oh, nice.
71 drones to 63 probes right now. This is so close. A lot of Hydras are being produced. He may feel like he needs that right now to deal with the Blink Stalkers.
The gold base is almost mined out, too. So this like resource boost he's getting,
it's about to be three base.
Yeah.
And that, for Protoss, is always nice.
And by the way, guys, it's actually going to be very doable for him for the Protoss to take a gold base here in a little bit if they're on
Demon's
base.
Oh, my God.
You know what I mean?
We have Colossi being produced, Tasteless, against a mass of Hydras.
A pride of Hydras.
You know, Nesty was owning him so hard until those DTs ran by. I can't believe this. Tails with this amazing comeback. Could he possibly actually defeat Nesty?
At this point in time, the MVP team is actually like standing up as they watch this.
Yeah, they are. They are actually going crazy. Everyone on IM.
Scratching their
pensive
ears they don't have. Pensive, great word choice. Our viewers now going to have better SAT scores because of you.
But worse because of me, too, because they're watching StarCraft instead of studying.
That's okay.
That makes you a smarter human, though. Don't worry.
All right. He's going to have two Colossus out, and that's pretty good.
Okay. So I think we might possibly see another drop. Hydra's always really good in drops.
He should actually make a load of Zealots here. He should actually probably...
Oh, my God, Tasteless. Here we go.
No. He should not. Well, I don't know.
Yeah, Nessie's going for the drop, Tasteless. And, oh my God, oh my God! Here we go! A bunch of Stalkers blinking huge!
Oh!
This is huge! Nessie may lose this game due to that blink right there. These Colossi just cleaning up Nessie's roaches. All that is left from this drop. Sickest nerd chills ever. Tails pushing forward right now. Nessie's in a lot of trouble. He's supply capped and big. He can't make any units, Tasteless.
He's going to force those drones to evacuate. I don't know if he's going to try to destroy the hatchery. He may just try to regroup and take the gold. But right now, Nesty definitely behind. He's actually supply blocked at 149 against 120. And this means the Protoss is now ahead in supply. Also, the angling here of the armies is going to be a little bit better here for the Protoss.
Oh, my God. This is absolutely maddening, Tasteless. They thought they were an army of one, but apparently they're an army of two. Sonic has a sequel, and in it you use Tails.
Wow. Nice force fields here, forcing the army to split up. Mowing down a few overlords. Oh, nice.
And he is supply capped once again.
He's continuing to keep him supply capped.
Nesty with great micro, moving back before the Colossi do too much damage.
All right, he's definitely got a dominant position right now.
Oh, yes,
Nesty
he does.
Is, like, up against the ropes.
In fact, he's got
he's going to take out this hatchery. This is smart. Just take out a production facility. And then you clean up all the creep around that area, too.
All the units popping out are dying as well, which is really, really bad for Nesty. Nesty right now is in scramble mode, Tasteless. He does not have that much. Tails is just doing a sick reinforcement. Dark Templars. ST is not going to be happy. All right, he's making a lot of banelings, going for a drop.
Uh-oh, this angle is
going to be too.
He's going to
try
to force field this.
Oh, God. Oh, Tasteless.
Force field.
Look at that. I think Tails has got this, Tasteless. He's at 189 to 159.
Protoss is now maxed out. He will lose out. One Colossus dropping
Nesty's
in over here.
He's going for
this
it.
This is the final drop. But look, he's blinking
Nesty's
everywhere.
Nesty's dead, man. It's over.
MVP is so, so happy right now. Nobody thought they would do it.
Nobody thought they would do it.
I don't know if MVP thought they could do it, but they are now.
After a happy start, I am off with a 3-0 lead. Don Gregu and Tails fight back, and GG, MVP going crazy.
That just happened. Oh,
wow.
My God. One of the greatest days of Team League ever.
Tails taking out 6 GSL champions right there.
This is actually insane.
Between well, he's MVP- got quite a story to tell. I bet you thought I'd say tail. No!
All right.
He just drank an ST.
Oh, he just drank an ST. That actually just happened. Pounding an ST that actually...
Wow.
Damn.
You know what? That is amazing because Nest T had such a lead. He was like, lol, get out. That
Dark
T run by
lead,
doing
force fields,
everything.
Everything was so well done by Tails. Who is this guy? Well, now he's a legend. Between... Oh, yeah, that is... I am so unhappy.
Oh, my God, that's just sadness. Don't get another camera shot of that, please.
I know.
God, ruined my night. This has been a great night. I see them and I'm just like, oh my God, I'm so sorry, guys. I want to go over and hug them all. By the way, that build he did against MVP is so stolen.
Oh, it's really good.
It's so my new build.
I loved the moment when he had that lead. He knew how to keep it. A worser player might have just been like, okay, 2 base. Do a timing push, and ST is just cranking out roaches, expecting that. Then he expands.
Yeah.
Tails.
No, I thought he was going all in from there because still Nest T had a big supply lead.
Yeah.
You know, the DTs and then catching those overlords, he actually killed an entire army for free with that. Who knows what would have happened if he had not blinked under those overlords. I can't believe Nest T loaded those up when he knew the proximity.
He should not have done that, but it was also a very smart move for Tails to engage.
Well, it was a move that Nest T needed to do. It invested so much in Hydras. When you do that with drops against someone going Colossus, you have to drop them and do some significant damage. But it was not done. Oh, my God. What a day. What a day.
Let's take a look at the match results.
I'm happy going 3-0. Then Don Gregu going 3-0. Then MVP going 1-0. And then Tails going 2-0. That's how it went.
We got to game number 9. Exactly 3 hours and 50 minutes later, we know that MVP could take out a team as legendary as I am.
Wow. Tails.
Tails.
Tails, tails, tails.
Time to quit the Sonic series and start playing StarCraft 2.
Wow.
You want rings? We can give you rings. Tails gonna have like so many rings on each finger. He can't even like move his joints like this. He plays StarCraft like this now. Yeah, because he got so many rings.
He has to get like his fingers don't bend like that anymore. They're just like this. So he has to get a big keyboard.
He gets more rings.
Like,
so he puts them on his neck, so his neck goes up higher.
Oh, those hill tribes in Thailand.
Are they in Thailand?
Yeah, I almost got to go see them on my trip.
That's so.
But the guy I booked the trip through messed it up, and I went to a flower garden instead. I was so angry.
Oh, that's so bad.
It was bad.
Nest T actually lost. Actually, what's insane is not just that Nest T lost, because everybody's human.
Except Nest T.
Except
Nest
T, but still, you know, even the non-humans can lose.
Yeah.
But to beat MVP and then Nest T, knowing that both MVP and Nest T were bringing their A games because they knew they had to win because they were getting down to the wire because Don Gregu took out too many IM players.
He did it just right, too. I mean, he took out... In a completely straight-up fashion, he took out MVP.
Right.
It was just a brilliantly played game. Awesome.
MVP
I'm so happy
went all in. He like deflected.
Yeah. But Nest T, he did get a little bit lucky. Well, you know, it's not like you make 3 DTs while losing your Warp Gate Rush and right-clicking in their main base and say, I got him. No.
Yeah.
It was a mistake there by Nest T.
We're going to go on to the interview now.
So 오늘 경기 승리 팀이죠. MVP 팀 만나보도록 하겠습니다. 자, 오늘 MVP 선수 바로 김원영 선수입니다. 정말 대단해요. 어떻게 그런 큰 일을 했는지. 정말 대단합니다. 기분이 어떠세요?
진짜
How do you feel? 아니,
개인 리그 성적을 못 내가지고 네네. 걱정했는데 여기서 성적 내서 진짜 기분 엄청 좋아요.
네, 그
I'm not doing well in the individual league, so I'm very happy to win today.
정종현 선수와 또 임재덕 선수까지 꺾으셨어요. 경기 딱 하기 전에 아, 이 선수 정말 대단한데 뭐 긴장 같은 거 하지 않으셨는지.
아, 제가 요즘에
Weren't you nervous playing against those two?
적그전 테란전이 진짜 연습하면 거의 다 이겨요.
아, 네.
그래서 좀 자신 있었는데 그래도 상대가 워낙 커리어도 좋고 해서
When I practice, I'm very strong against Sir Terran, so I was pretty confident going into the match.
제가 저번에 프라임전에서 이정원 선수랑 할 때 그때 좀 무대 경기할 때 긴장해서
네 익숙지 않아서요.
그때부터 나아진 것 같아요.
아,
긴장하는 게.
네, 알겠습니다.
I tend to get nervous playing on stage.
이렇게 강팀,
but I think I overcame that today.
그 결승전까지 갈 수 있겠다라는 생각도 들 것 같아요. NSO전에 임하는 각오 한마디 해주시죠.
IM전이 진짜 제일 어렵다고 생각했어요.
네네네.
근데 이겨서 그런지 다음에 NSO전 때는 팀원들이 모두 다 긴장도 안 하고 제 실력 발휘할 것 같아요.
네, 알겠습니다. IM was going to be the hardest team to play against. 이렇게 좋은 경기 보여주면서 희망이 있을 것 같습니다. 고맙습니다.
네.
네. 네, 그리고 최현상 감독님, 안녕하세요.
Interview with
아,
coach
정말
now.
정말 기분 좋으실 것 같아요. 어떠세요?
네, 아, 오늘은 좀 주체할 수 없을 정도로 너무 기쁘네요.
감독님 말씀하신 대로 진짜 한 편의 드라마 이변이 yeah. 일어났어요.
Overall?
그렇죠. 스포츠에서 누구나 생각하는 강팀을
네네네.
조금 객관적인 전력에서 약간 팀이 이겼을 때 예, 드라마가 연출된다고 하는데 그 주인공이 아, 저희 팀이 됐고 또 우리 선수들이 돼서 너무나
기쁘습니다. 네,
사실 김원영 선수의 기용이 의외이긴 했지만 지금 정말 멋진 일을 해줬단 말이에요. 네. 김원영 선수의 기용이 특별한 이유가 있었나요?
사실 마지막에 정종현 선수가 먼저 나오면 김원영 선수가 나가고 임재덕 선수가 먼저 나오면은 최도준 선수가 나가기로 했는데 정정현 선수가 먼저 나와서 김현 선수가 나가게 된 거고요. 오늘 올 때 한번 물어봤더니 감독님 저 오늘은 풀전 말고는
토요나
테란전에서는 자신 있습니다 이러더라고요. 그래서 기대는 했었는데 실제 그 기대를 실현시킬 줄은 사실 예 몰랐는데 예, 너무 기쁩니다.
Tails is very confident against MVP.
연신지 웃고 계시는데
And he's proved himself today.
다음 주에 NSO와의 경기 남아 있어요. 또 이기셔야 할 텐데 NSO와의 박용식 감독한테 한마디 해주시죠.
아 우선 오늘도 보셔서 아시겠지만 저희 팀 몇 점 앞선다고 해서 이기신 게 아닙니다. 끝날 때까지 아마 긴장 늦추시면 안 되실 것 같고요. 저희 팀 선수들 다 지금 아 오늘만 이기면 우승할 수 있을 것 같다라는 말을 아까 했거든요. 근데 예, 그 사이에 이제 NSO팀과 만나게 돼서 예, 발판으로 삼고 올라가겠습니다.
네, 멋진 경기 기대하겠습니다. 예. 감사합니다. 네. 네, 저는 지금까지 오늘의 승리팀 MVP팀을 만나봤습니다. 다음 주
And that does it. Jeez. What an upset we cast today. And it was not just like an upset within one game. It was an upset of an entire team. MVP has really proved to themselves and the rest of the world that they are actually able to be legend killers.
Happy start out with a 3-0.
I know.
And they lost.
Think about that. And it was Happy that started that lead out. It wasn't like they had an ST start out with that lead. Happy started out with a 3-0 lead, and MVP managed to come back.
Swear to God, that build by Tails.
Both their builds.
I don't know. That might be the best build in PVT. That might be the best. I'm gonna copy the hell out of it and play it and figure that out.
it would be really good on a 1-on-1 map. Absolutely. Good. Maybe Zelnaga Caverns as well. Then again, it might be best on Crosshair because you can hold a one base all in. Zelnaga Caverns is a little bit trickier. But yeah, man. I mean, that's a pretty scary build. I'm really impressed. I want to mess around with that as well. Are you hungry?
Yeah, let's go.
Need dinner. I need some food.
Have a beer.
I'm famished.
Cool
beer.
Down.
It's Friday.
Then you can go home with your hurt ankle.
I know. I can limp home.
All right.
The taxi won't make a U-turn at my street.
I know.
So I'm gonna have to like bribe him because I can't
give
go up that
five
hill.
Bucks to do a U-turn here. He's like, all right.
What
like,
I need is actually
he's like
up,
reaching back to
up
get
the hill
while
of my apartment.
It.
I need like that, like those chairs that old ladies use that go up staircases, like the one they had in Gremlins. That's what I need.
Yeah. Yeah. You got to be careful though, man.
Well, let's take a look at the brackets now.
Well, we're going to have Prime against TSL, NS Hoso against MVP. left side of the bracket, old teams. Right side of the bracket, new teams.
New.
New versus old versus new. Tasteless and Artosis. Moltrap, Della, and Wolf. The GSL, Mr. Che. John the Translator.
Don't forget John. Che the
Sir
Producer.
Sir Karen, Protoss, cameras, chairs, keyboard, mouse.
And tomorrow is AOL Arena of Legends.
DRG versus MVP once again. Woo! And then the winner versus Huck. And then Group D, Slayer's Boxer against Jelaya. And winner against Nanawa. It's amazing.
Wow.
What an amazing day. You guys are so lucky. You're actually spoiled.
You guys are actually spoiled
by all these wonderful games.
Actually, they are so spoiled.
They are so spoiled, man.
You should get at home. He's like, crush him. He's like, I'm not spoiled.
I like to treat people. But you know what? This has gone too far. I'm going to be talking to their mother.
This is actually that MTV. It's my sweet 16 birthday party. It's like, Dad didn't get me a cake that looked like a car that was the size of a car. And I'm like, I want to kick your little 16-year-old ass. You are so ungrateful right now, you little brat. You've seen that show, right?
I've heard about it. I haven't watched it.
These spoiled kids and their parents, like these really rich families, it's like their sweet 16 birthday party, but it's like a birthday party that like no one will ever be able to afford. They're like starving people in foreign countries, and I'm just sitting there like,
I want a birthday party like that. Will you give it to me, Tasis?
Yeah, I will. Yay. I will. Why are we leaning back like this? We're like talking to the hey, what's up? What's up, guys?
Well, for me, this is like, after this is like the same feeling
like
I have after
arms,
sex, man. I just need to lean back. It's been amazing. What a great set of matches. Thank you guys.
Thank you guys for joining us. We'll be back again with more GSL action here in the up and coming week. Take care.